tell you, it can be expensive. But sometimes you can get local radio stations to partner with you. We in Will County have been very, very successful. We have a small local radio station that has extreme loyal listeners. And the loyal listeners are kind of the movers and shakers around our entire county. The radio station takes great pains to cover high school sporting events. Wow, there's some good listeners for you. And they cover, they talk to the newspaper editors throughout the county, so any newspaper that's out there that editors would be interviewed at least twice each week on what's going on. They interview mayors, school superintendents, township folks occasionally, and of course county board members. So we can get them to partner with us on an event. We get a huge amount of free publicity. Sometimes they'll even come and do a free live radio broadcast at the event. We've had them where they gave out t-shirts. They got a sponsor and they gave t-shirts. Anybody who came to the event, talk about an incentive, and I don't have to pay anything for it. So it's that kind of relationships. If you can build those, try to find them. And it doesn't mean that the larger radio stations don't have them. It's just kind of trying to tap into them, bringing out what you're doing for them, they're doing for you. Paper shredding events. Sometimes you can do that with a bank, or you can do that with H&R Block or some other kind of accounting company that is kind of worried about people's privacy papers. So you can find partners like that, do something on the radio with them. Television, occasionally you can do some stuff on your cable access. So if you can do a video and get your local municipality to throw it up on the cable access, you can go with that. And then if you have a little bit more money, you might be able to get onto the cable channels. Okay, now I know that's hard. It's not like it used to be. You've got the dish and you've got people who, you know, are T-belling and, you know, they're not really tuned in all the time. But that is another avenue. We actually did that. We experimented with it. We had a little bit of money and we tried it. We got some good success from it. Not stellar. Not something that necessarily justifies all the money. But at the same time, had we partnered with it and we were sharing the cost of that with somebody else and giving them some credit in the ad, say, you know, the recycling company that we're working with or something, it might have made a lot more financial sense. So we look at that occasionally every year or two. We go back and we can see what we can do. Billboards. I will tell you that a regular billboard, the way that they, you know, most of them are out there, where they're stagnant, you're buying them for a 30-day period at least, they're pretty expensive. I have never personally purchased that type of billboard advertising. But they have new billboards now that are electronic. So now they're running multiple ads all month long. And you're buying just a little piece of that. And that's been very effective for us. We had the best turnout that we've ever had for a textile collection event this past year, collected the most we've ever collected. We had a great turnout for House of Hazardous. We've got a lot of calls on an upcoming book event that we're having. All of them use electronic billboards. And we know we're reaching people we've never reached before. We know it. So it's a really nice option. Buses. If you've got a public bus system in your area, you might talk to them not about the outside advertising, which can be pretty expensive. Maybe some inside advertising. They can have a deal a lot of times on stuff. So now you're only reaching the people who are riding that bus, but let's think about those people for a minute. They're already using mass transit. Hey, they're kind of green. Let's build on them. So that's another thing. And then one of the other things that I've seen with the whole issue of people not watching television the way they used to is there's a movement towards advertising in your movie theater. So have a conversation with your local movie theater. They will run local advertising. See if they give you a deal, you know, what you can do with them. And you know, if all you're doing is a standard picture with, you know, call this about, it doesn't have to be that you get some great movie trailer going here. It can just be something really simple. And then, like I mentioned a little earlier, partnering. So partnering for funding, partnering to get retailers to post your signs, posters, that kind of thing. Finding somebody who might split an ad with you, your vendors, or just people who want to be perceived as doing something right in the community and they want their name associated with you. Churches, some churches will put your flyers in their bulletin. You can also, and it's very, very cost effective sometimes, you can put your logo and your website name and stuff just on the back of the church bulletin. And very inexpensive. expensive. If they do charge at all, some won't even charge you. They'll just let you put it in. So it's something to check into. Being a government entity, I can tell you that we kind of shy away. We don't want anybody to perceive us as, you know, mixing up with church and state. But I know other government entities that did not get into that quandary. But certainly, as a private business, it's something to consider as well. Flyers in schools. We used to have the greatest success. We would have an event, and we would go to the grade school and even the middle school students. They would all take these lovely little 8.5 by 11 flyers home, and it was perfect. The parents learned about it. We had a tremendous rate. You can see how many people found out on a flyer. Then the schools did something to save paper. They went to what's called a virtual backpack. My kids' schools did this. I don't know if it's everywhere, but I know that it's certainly widespread in my area. It's great. The schools are saving a lot of paper, and that is wonderful. The problem is now you bring your flyer in, they scan your flyer and put it in the virtual backpack. And as I mentioned earlier, I got other things to do, and if I am going out to the website, it's when is the kids' concert coming up? When's that game I have to go to? Where is it at? I'm not going into the virtual backpack to see who's advertising their upcoming events. So we've really seen a huge downturn in getting the kids to get that message from the parents. Yeah. So you win some, you lose some. We find other ways. Sometimes if we're having the event near the school, will actually put a sign up for us. So all those parents who are even driving to and from the kids, they'll see the sign up there. So we've done other things like that. Again, that's back to signs. Staffing a booth at local events, really important. Gets you outreach right to your constituency. Now you have some people who, you know, will share with you why they think you're nonsense. And then you have other people who share with you why they think you're awesome. And hopefully, you know, you get converted to doing your program. When you're doing those kinds of things, you want to look at promotional materials and how much do those things cost. Certainly, having a tablecloth with your logo works. Without divulging any names, one of my employers had a lovely black tablecloth for every time we did a special event. Black shirtster, really easily, and doesn't say a thing about anything we're doing or who we are. And some of those events, you've got a lot of salespeople that you're competing with, and here you are, I just want to give you information. It's all, I even have some checklists for you. Okay, free. Now, they don't want to talk to you because they just talked to 5 people who are trying to sell them stuff. Having your logo can really help because now they know who you are, okay, and whether or not they really want to approach you. So that's a great thing, and it doesn't cost a lot. It's not much different than buying just a plain cable. A banner. I brought my banner, you guys, and I apologize. It's actually in the office over there. I forgot to grab it for this presentation. So, but it's a screen that, and you'll see them. They're in the exhibit hall. Several people have them. I got to tell you, I used to use the table toppers. They're cumbersome. They're heavy. Then you got your bags of goodies you're going to give out. You're making 2 or 3 trips to the car. The banner, it rolls up. It's like this long. And it's easy to put up in seconds. Really, I can't beat it, and it's actually very inexpensive to get one. So I highly recommend those. You can have 2 or 3 of them decorated right behind your table over the desk. Pencils and pens are pretty darn cheap. Make sure you get recycled content. If you're doing a green message, for goodness sake, you want to make sure you're keeping it consistent. I'm a big fan of practical. I don't want to, you know, that lovely toy all the kids get at McDonald's, and then it's like in the garden 3 weeks later. Okay, what's the point? We're not trying to create garbage. Trying to do something sustainable. So making sure what you get somebody is practical. Magnets. Okay? Make sure the magnet will hold up something. Okay? Even if it's just a magnet that's flat, just, you know, somebody's going to put on the refrigerator, it's normally so they can also put a piece of paper under it. So I know, getting the cheapest magnet isn't the best way to go. Okay? Things like that. And then again, make sure you have a logo or a consistent message people start to recognize you by. That's always a good thing. And then my closing here, I'm getting close here. The word on your word choices. Try to be positive, be upbeat. Even if you're thinking, oh my gosh, nobody's ever going to do this because, you know, I'm getting all this flack from everybody. You want your message to always be positive, right? And then think about words that allow people to be open to change. I got to tell you, when I started way back in the late 80s, you could recycle just a few types of paper, and just a few. Newsprint. High-grade white paper. the frozen food boxes. It's all fine. All right, excellent. Great. Made wonderful progress. I will tell you right now, I don't go to an event. But I'll have somebody come up to me and I wash out my last jar and I take the label off. What? Why are you doing that?
Okay.
Well, I learned that back in 1980 something. Okay. Don't do it anymore. Waste your time, waste your water. 3,000 degrees Fahrenheit furnace doesn't really care if there's a paper label on that thing. Okay, so let's just go with it. If you're really dedicated, great, but why? Why bother? Words like e-waste. And you know what? It's used. Lots of people still use it. Better word would be e-scrap. You want people thinking about this, not something they're getting rid of forever in the landfill or the local incinerator or wherever it's going. They want to think about something they're going to use. Okay? So scrap. They understand scrap gets reused, recycled. Same with the food. You don't want to call it food waste, but you can avoid it. You want to call it food scrap. And there's lots of things like that. So just kind of keep that in mind as you're messaging. Not currently available, not currently accepted. That gets people thinking about the idea that this item might be accepted somewhere else. So yes, plastic bags are not accepted in my curbside program. But that doesn't mean plastic bags aren't recyclable. So if I put not accepted, period, and I have this list of all these items that don't go on my curbside program, and it says plastic bags and electronics, I'm just giving everybody the impression that now they can't do anything with it. When in fact, all they just had to do was go to the drop-off with it. So you want to just say, not currently accepted in this program. You might want to put an asterisk and then give like a little verb somewhere else on where you could take those items. And then when you are going to quote sources of information, use some highly respected sources like the Environmental Protection Agency. All right? Try to avoid controversial extremist groups as your sources of information. Guaranteed some of your audience will be turned off. You might be a big fan. You might be a member. That's awesome. Avoid using them in your publications. Okay? They're not your sources because they are seen as extremists and people just won't buy into them.
Just one second. When you're all finished, if you will see me at the registration, I would be more than happy to give you your drink tickets. Thank you.
Keep it fresh. Try new ideas, okay? Don't let things get stale. And then measure your results, which you heard this morning in the keynote. Measure, measure, measure. Always very important. And last, have fun. Have fun with this. This is marketing. I'm sorry, I think marketing is one of those.